enjoy delicious food and have the opportunity to experience the wonders of Mount San Jacinto State Park and Wilderness. If you didn't have the opportunity, have one of the state park volunteers guide you through a relaxing and wonderful trip. You might want to put this on your list of things to do when you visit us again. As we descend from the mountaintop, you see below you the desert cities of the Coachella Valley. Straight ahead in our line of travel is the city of Desert Hot Springs, with Highway 62, that's the road that joins free, to the city's left. Closer to us and to the right of our travel is the city of Palm Springs. Going farther to the right of our travel is Cathedral City, Rancho Mirage, Indian Wells, Palm Desert, La Quinta, Indio, and Coachella. You may have noticed many windows you see to the left of our travel. Those whirling blades are powered by the almost constant winds that pour out the mouth of the manual panel. The electricity that these windmills generate is sufficient to power thousands of homes in our state. Well, why don't you get back and enjoy the view of beautiful Coachella Valley, and be back.
Well, the aerial tramway was authorized by California legislature in 1945, completed in 1963. It goes 2.5 miles and covers about 5,000 feet in elevation gain. Down below us, you see Chino Canyon. That's where the tram starts. And up above is the mountain, right, mountain station. Since the tram is rotating, when there's a lot of people, you get your spot with your view, and then the other time you don't, so I'm gonna soak it in. Normally the tram can hold up to 80 people, but during COVID, not so much. I think 16 is the max. We're about maxed out now. I can imagine 80 people on here. I might be kind of scared. Here comes the swaying tower, the biggest sway. So we're gonna feel kind of like you can see it rotating. Down below us is the Coachella Valley, which stretches to the Salton Sea. That's where I'm headed, down to Slab City. Here comes the fun sway. Not feng sway. Fun sway. Here we go. Whoa.
We're about halfway home now, and it's your last chance to breathe in some of that great mountain air.
Thank you.
just passed the snow line.
Down below, you'll soon be able to see the tank that stores the water collected from the streams that flow in the canyon. That water, and for that matter, all of the food, materials, and other provisions that are used in the mountain station have to be transported up on these tram cars. Water from the valley station is pumped into the tanks that attach to the bottom of the cars, which are then emptied at the mountain station. Each car can carry 800 gallons of water. Now, we limit that, depending on how many guests we're transporting in each car. We'll be pulling into the Valley Station dock in just a few minutes. Know that you take with you memories of great adventure. Visit to a state park that encompasses 13,000 acres of pristine wilderness, 54 miles of hiking trails, and 6 primitive campgrounds. But I doubt you covered it all today. Depending on the time of year you visit, you could see one or more of the 14 different mammals who call the mountain home. From deer mice, California Miota's bat, ring-tailed cat, and the bobcat, and maybe a mountain lion or coyote. They're all there to see. Or you might spot some of the 63 species of birds, such as the golden eagle, Steller's jay, dark-eyed junco, red-tailed hawk, white-headed woodpecker. You get it. There's just too much to be experienced in just one visit to this magnificent mountain.
All I caught was there's 800 gallons of water this thing can hold, and they wouldn't give me any. I'm so thirsty. COVID. Can't have water.
Do you need water?
I'm being funny. I'm just doing a video. Yeah, I'm good. That's been the big, I've been traveling since May. You can't get water anywhere. Like when you're traveling with a backpack, good luck. You gotta go pay like $4 a gallon sometimes, you know?
Oh my God.
You can't even afford to live off that. In the desert, you gotta drink like 2 gallons a day too.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's time to remind you to be careful.
I was drinking snowmelt the past couple of days.
Oh, by the way, if you didn't have a chance to shop for that souvenir while on the mountain,
I just used my little burner fire thing, so it took a few minutes, but it didn't taste good.
That's also find a copy of the CD.
Is that a what? Oh, yeah, it is. It's a close sale.
By Otmar Weaver.
I like the ones that aren't close sale, but in the desert, they'll get popped. Get like a $200 sleeping pad that pops in like 30 places. You're going to buy an $8 sleeping mat after that.
Welcome back to the Valley Station, ladies and gentlemen. Please continue to watch your balance. We may bump the sides coming into the dock here.